Hello, my name is Ashutosh Trivedi. I'm a master's student at International Institute of Information Technology, Bangalore. My co-author, Srisha Rao, is a professor at International Institute of Information Technology, Bangalore. In this video, we will present many simulations we have carried out during our study of emergency evacuations. Before we move on to simulations, a brief introduction about our work. As we know, in emergency situations, sometimes there is a requirement to evacuate people, or in any mass gathering, there is a chance of stampede due to fire and earthquakes. Currently, there are approaches which model the crowd behavior in normal conditions, but there is a lack of model which explains crowd behavior in panic situations. We propose an agent-based model to study the behavior of individual in escape panic. Our model also helps in designing better evacuation strategies ahead of any mass gathering. In our study, we identified the psychological factors which may cause panic during evacuation, and we have incorporated those factors in our multi-agent system. We also propose a general framework to evaluate different evacuation strategies, which in turn helps in identifying possible bottlenecks and shortcomings during evacuation. Now let's move on to simulations. In this first case, we have 400 agents trying to evacuate a room by only one exit door. An agent is shown by a circle in 2D plane. Green ones are the one with no panic and red ones are the one which have high panic. Green to red color transition shows the increase in panic. Black agents are injured agents which cannot move. We can observe the jamming and herding behavior of crowd near the exit door. We can also observe the arc-like formation of the crowd. By hovering the cursor over an agent, we can get the values of physical force and panic it is experiencing. We can clearly figure out that one exit door is not enough for these many agents in this environment. In the following cases, we have studied the environment with two exit doors at different positions and also with different visibilities. In this case, both the doors are in middle of the room with high visibility, which means all the agents have information about both doors. We can clearly observe very less injuries and also evacuation time is less. In this case, we have both the doors at the opposite corners of the room with high visibility. In this case also, the crowd is equally divided between the doors, but we will observe that the evacuation time is more than the case 2. Also, the injuries are more than the previous case. Of course, this case is worse than case 2. When we have two doors, doors in the middle are preferred over doors at the opposite corner. Case 4 has two exit doors in the middle of the room, but one is with low visibility. This scenario occurs when one of the doors is less known to the crowd, like emergency exits. The crowd tends to ignore the emergency doors and show herding behavior towards the one door which is more known to the crowd. We found that the evacuation time is not much less than the case which has only one door. So it is very important to educate crowd about the emergency exits. This case illustrates a crowd behavior in unknown environment when both the doors are less visible. It clearly shows the herding behavior of crowd. Of course, the evacuation time is very high for this case. Now we will illustrate the agent's behavior when we introduce obstacles in the environment. Due to bottlenecks introduced by the obstacle, we see that the case with two exit doors in the middle is no longer better. We can see very high panic among the crowd, and clearly we need evacuation strategy in such situation, which should be planned ahead by signage and communication or prior training. Now we will illustrate the case of lecture hall evacuation. In this case, we have 160 agents in a lecture hall environment where upper door has low visibility and lower door has high visibility. This case illustrates how we can design the evacuation strategy and also evaluate among different strategies. As you can see, we identify these nodes in the environment for our evacuation strategies. This is the roadmap created on the environment to explain our strategy. We can observe the coordinated queuing behavior in the passages. We can also see that lower door is more crowded due to high visibility. We could also identify a bottleneck near the lower door. Panic among the crowd is very low, which resulted in very less injuries. So we can see that this evacuation strategy is actually successful in evacuating 160 agents in this lecture hall. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any further queries or questions about our simulation and our study, please contact me at this mail address.